McDaniel runs the floor. Muggsy Bogues swats it away, but McDaniel prevails, and he's got six.
Good defense almost by Charlotte. Muggsy right there again in the midst of everything.
Oh, wow. Larry Johnson leveled Xavier McDaniel, and now Moore may break out.
Well, I predicted this was going to be a tough game, and Xavier McDaniel's right in the midst of it.
McDaniel gave Curry a hard shot off a screen. Johnson saw it, and he said no more. And he leveled McDaniel.
Trying to protect his teammate, but he's got to stay in the ballgame himself. Now, McDaniels bumps Curry, and Johnson clears McDaniels out. And Rick Fox, in trying to plead the case a little too vehemently, gets hit with the tech.
We have, I think, technicals at both ends. There'll be a technical on Larry Johnson, an offensive foul on Larry Johnson for the screen, and a technical on Rick Fox at the other end.
First, the Chuck comes right on Dale Curry, and Larry, trying to protect his teammate, maybe he didn't hit Xavier quite that hard. I think Xavier sort of gave him a little bit of flop for emphasis.
And McDaniel heads to the sidelines to pick up a towel.
And Larry Johnson is getting the fans in the ballgame. And, you know, we talked about it early on in game three, what these fans mean to the Charlotte Hornets. And I think that crowd on Monday night had a real big impact on the game's outcome. And now they are involved again.
Trying to distract McDaniel at the foul line. The sixth man did the job. Now, I think the call on Larry is going to be a flagrant foul. McDaniel bricks two. Charlotte will have the ball. Assess technicals to Larry and also Rick Fox.
And what you have to be very careful about, you know, your second technical is an ejection.
That's
so
right.
You have to be very careful there. It's going to be the second half. Don't forget you got one tech in the first half.
And McDaniel doesn't have a technical. Charlotte by 8, 44-36. McDaniel, ball pushed away by Muggsy Bogues.
Muggsy and Kendall doing the double team D on McDaniel. Good play by Kendall. He gets the block.
Here's Douglas. In the lane, two on the shot clock. Nice tip by Rick Fox.
At the passers, they don't have the dribblers, and Charlotte's making them pay.
6-0. The Hornets answer the physical fisticuffs of Boston with a 6-0. It's going to be an 8-0 run. And a foul.
And Kendall thought Sherman was a little excessive, and now he's a little upset. Sherman actually, I think, made a pretty good play.
Alan Bristow going down to talk to Kendall Gill. I think Kendall wants a flagrant foul called on Douglas.
Kendall has a clear breakaway, and Douglas, yes he does, gets Kendall right in the back with his left hand and then swings. It should be a flagrant. It should be called a flagrant.
And it's going to be called that way. They must be consistent. If they're going to call that offensive foul on Larry Johnson, they've got to be consistent and not let Sherman Douglas get away with a flagrant foul.
You can't get your chest to the back of the offensive player on a fast break if you have no defender on your team in front of that player. It's almost like a call in hockey, Steve, and that's what happened. Douglas had his chest to Kendall's back when there were only two players, nobody in between the basket. You can't do that. You'll see it here. There's Douglas's chest right in Kendall's back. Flagrant foul, right call.
Gill to the line. Well, we haven't sent any Celtics to the penalty box, but they're making big scores. 14 points for Kendall Gill, 51-38. And we have a timeout coming up, or is that a technical?
No, you got Chris Paul trying to get a timeout.
All right, timeout on the court with 3:19 left to play.